good afternoon. My name's Rob Ray. My friends call me Smokey. Behind me here is an airplane that 30 years ago, we were paired up for an event that would kind of stay with me for a long time afterward. I was deployed down to the Philippines from the 14th Fighter Squadron Samurai in Japan. And at that time I was an F-16 pilot, and my squadron would go down to the Philippines probably twice a year. And during this particular day, our mission was to provide training for ourselves and actually for the USS Nimitz, which was docked at QB Point at the QB Naval Air Station there in the Philippines. We took off as a flight of four. The first two airplanes, one and two, aborted due to some problems, mechanical problems. So my wingman and I continued on for the mission, which was a simulated attack on the USS Nimitz. The mission would take us out over the South China Sea, about 100 miles. We'd refuel, and we would start a attack run in at low altitude over the water to ingress to the point where we were attacking the Nimitz, which was in port. They also had their defenses up, and there were also simulated Red Air aircraft, which actually were U.S. Navy F-18s, and they were providing us adversary support. The mission went as briefed up until a point where I started my attack, which was required the airplane to be climbed at a 45 degree angle, and it required minimum afterburner thrust to get the airplane up to the altitude to do the simulated delivery. During the actual climb, when I lit the afterburner, moved the throttle up to the afterburner position, pretty much every light in the cockpit came on. Several people on the ground were yelling, in the air, in the pop, check engines, you're on fire. And at that point, my mind kind of raced, and I thought, wow, some poor guy's on fire. And then I realized, well, hey, that's me. Sure was, as I looked over my shoulder, I saw the smoke coming out of the back of the airplane. And at that point, it was all into training, where I was blessed to actually remember what we were supposed to do at that point. My wingman, who was an outstanding support role at this point, was providing the information on how the airplane looked, which was not good at that point. It burned most of what you see behind me, where the rudder is, just below the 7 and 557, this entire piece that stuck out the rear here. That white thing right there is a rudder servo. In both sides of that rudder servo, A and B system hydraulics are routed. So both A and B system hydraulics were being depleted through the fire coming out the back of the engine, which was going up through that part of the tail that was there. Burned most of that off, and the rudder was gone, removed from the rear of the airplane. I was very fortunate, and I was very blessed to get it on the ground. It's in one piece. With the extreme wonderful help of my wingman, Dennis Braun, who was flying right beside me the entire time, giving me really good information as to what I had, which was 0% A system hydraulics and about 10% B when I finally got it on the ground, which isn't very much. So anyway, sitting here behind me 30 years later, 557 is still obviously a flyable airplane. They're putting it back together to become a drone, which makes me a little bit sad because some young guys are going to get to go out and shoot at it, which I guess in a way means it's going to get to fly again. And actually my hometown is Panama City, Florida, where this airplane is going to end up. So that's kind of cool too. And interestingly enough, when we showed up in the hangar here today, directly next to 557, 399, my squadron, after I left the active duty Air Force, was the 160th Fighter Squadron, Alabama Air National Guard. This airplane was one of my squadron airplanes. I've flown it many, many times over Iraq and some other parts of the world on several combat missions. This airplane was I was flying it the very first day of Operation Iraqi Freedom. My wingman and I went out and patrolled Iraq for 6 hours and actually employed ordnance against some targets. I was flying 399, which when I walked in here today and saw those two together, I thought this is obviously something I didn't put together. This was divine intervention because it's pretty cool that they're both here. I'm very thankful to the personnel here at AMARC and especially Roger Meeker for allowing me to come out here today to talk to you about this. I'm very thankful that that I've been around long enough to be able to tell this story, and thank you very much for your time.
Very cool. There'll be days like this. footsteps of my dreams. There'll be days like this when people understand what I mean. There'll be days like this when you ring out the changes of how everything is. Well, my mama told me, yeah, there'll be days like this.